Daddy Pig's birthday.
Today is Daddy Pig's birthday. Daddy Pig has to go to work.
Daddy, I wish you didn't have to work on your birthday.
So do I. But I'll be home as soon as I can. See you later.
See you later.
While Daddy Pig is at work, we can get all his birthday surprises ready. First, we'll make Daddy's birthday cake. We start with butter and sugar and flour. Then we add an egg. And most important of all, the chocolate bits.
Ooh. Mummy Pig is making a chocolate cake. Daddy Pig loves chocolate cake.
I give it a stir.
Mummy, can I stir?
Yes, Peppa.
Peppa loves stirring. George wants a go.
Okay, George, that's enough stirring. There, Daddy Pig's chocolate cake.
Hooray!
Now, we just have to bake it in the oven.
Mummy, can I lick the spoon?
Yes, you can lick the spoon and George can lick the bowl.
Yippee!
Peppa and George love chocolate cake mixture.
Poor Daddy Pig. He's missing all the fun.
Mummy, can I ring Daddy at work and say happy birthday?
That's a nice idea.
This is the office where Daddy Pig works.
Hello, Mr. Rabbit speaking.
May I speak to Daddy Pig, please?
Someone for you, Daddy Pig. It sounds important.
Hello, Daddy Pig speaking.
Happy birthday, Daddy!
Happy birthday!
Thank you, Peppa.
Don't be late home, Daddy. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Happy birthday, Daddy Pig!
Thank you.
There's just one more thing to do before Daddy gets home.
Yes, Daddy's birthday surprise. Shh, George, remember, it's a secret.
Shh.
Peppa and George have buckets of water. Mummy Pig has balloons. I wonder what Daddy Pig's birthday surprise can be.
Daddy's home!
Quick, back to the house.
Daddy Pig is home from work.
Happy birthday, Daddy Pig!
Thank you, everyone. Wow, what a lot of candles.
That's because you are very, very old, Daddy. You must blow out all your candles in one go.
I'll do my best.
Hooray! And here's your birthday present.
Thank you. New boots. Fantastic. Let's try them out.
Peppa, George and Mummy Pig are wearing their boots. Daddy Pig is wearing his birthday boots. Daddy Pig has found a little puddle.
Let's see if these boots work.
The puddle is a bit too little for Daddy Pig.
What I need is a big puddle.
Why not try over here, Daddy Pig?
Ooh, what's this?
It's your special birthday surprise.
What are they up to?
A big muddy puddle.
Fantastic! My birthday boots work perfectly. Would you care to join me in my birthday muddy puddle?
Daddy Pig loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Everyone loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
This is my best birthday ever!
Cuckoo clock.
It is early morning. Mummy and Daddy Pig are still asleep.
What?
It's time to get up.
It's much too early. Don't you know what time it is, Peppa?
No, Daddy. Our clock doesn't work.
Oh, dear. Let's see if we can mend it. Ah, the old cuckoo clock.
Why is it called a cuckoo clock?
There's a little wooden bird inside called a cuckoo.
I've never seen the cuckoo.
That's because we stopped winding it a long time ago.
The cuckoo got a bit annoying.
Oh, can we wind it up again, please?
All right.
Daddy Pig is winding up the cuckoo clock.
There!
Daddy Pig sets the clock to the right time. It is nearly 9 o'clock.
Daddy, can we see the cuckoo now?
You'll see the cuckoo soon.
What does she look like, Daddy?
Now let me think. She moves her head like this. And she flaps her wings like this. And she says, ahem, cuckoo!
Cuckoo!
What a cuckoo. Noisy little cuckoo you are, George.
Cuckoo! Look, it's going to do something. Wow! Silly George, you missed the cuckoo. The cuckoo was really, really brilliant. She went cuckoo and you missed it.
Never mind, George. You can see cuckoo next time.
But you'll have to wait. Cuckoo only comes out once an hour.
Waiting is boring. Come on, George. Let's play outside.
George does not want to play outside. He is waiting to see cuckoo. It is nearly 10 o'clock. George has been waiting for cuckoo for almost an hour.
George, come and play. Mr. Dinosaur wants you to play too. Dinosaur.
George has missed cuckoo again.
Never mind, George. Why don't you play in the garden? I'll call you when it's time to see cuckoo.
To you, George.
It is nearly 11 o'clock.
Peppa! George! Time to see cuckoo.
Quick, George. You can't miss cuckoo again.
George is running faster than he has ever run before.
George, did you see cuckoo? Cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo.
Peppa and George love playing cuckoos.
Cuckoo, cuckoo.
It is night time. Peppa and George are very sleepy.
Cuckoo.
Peppa and George are asleep.
Is it morning already?
No. Time to sleep.
Cuckoo is not very well.
She just needs to sleep, like you and George.
Good night.
Good night, my little piggies.
George, I know how to make cuckoo better. We'll wind her up like Daddy did.
Mummy and Daddy are fast asleep.
What?
Mummy! Daddy, we've got something to show you. We've made cuckoo better. Fruit.
It is fruit day at the supermarket.
Look, it's Mr. Potato.
Mrs. Carrot.
Sweet Cranberry and Little Sprout.
Apple, orange, banana, pear and pineapple too. Eat 5 pieces of fruit a day because they're good for you.
Welcome to Fruit Day, where the magic of fruit never ends.
Wow, so much fruit.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello.
We are choosing our favourite fruit. What's your favourite?
I like apples.
I like oranges.
I like bananas.
I like carrots.
Carrots are not a fruit.
Oh,
carrots are a vegetable.
Edmund is a bit of a clever clogs.
What's your favourite fruit, George? Is it bananas?
Or oranges?
George likes strawberries the best.
Strawberry!
George loves strawberries.
Smoothies! Get your fruit smoothies here!
Hello, Miss Rabbit!
What's a fruit smoothie?
It's a drink made from fruit. Would you like one?
Yes, please! Can I have a smoothie with apples?
Okay, but smoothies can have lots of different fruit in them.
Okay, apples, raspberries, bananas, and more apples.
An apple, raspberry, banana, and more apples smoothie.
Mmm, delicious.
Can I have a smoothie, please?
Me too.
And me.
And me.
Of course. What fruit would you like in your smoothies?
I don't know.
It can be anything, Pedro.
Okay. Cheese, please.
Pedro, cheese isn't a fruit.
It has to be fruit or vegetables. Okay. Raspberries and blueberries and blackberries and gooseberries.
That's more like it. Raspberry and blueberry and blackberry and gooseberry smoothies for everyone.
Lovely.
What do you want in your smoothie, George?
Strawberry. George, a smoothie must have lots of fruit in it.
How about strawberries and pineapple, George?
No.
Maybe George would like some dinosaur juice.
Dinosaur juice?
Oh, yes. All dinosaurs like dinosaur juice.
Dinosaur.
Let's see. A bit of this, one of those, a few of these, or some of that. One dinosaur juice, just for dinosaurs and their little friends.
Dinosaur.
Can I have some dinosaur juice, please, Miss Rabbit?
Me too.
And me.
And me.
Okay, dinosaur juice for everyone. Oh, bother.
What's wrong, Miss Rabbit?
I've forgotten what I put in the dinosaur juice.
Oh,
I can tell you what was in it.
Really? How?
By smelling it.
Freddy Fox has a very good sense of smell.
There's one banana.
One banana.
Three. No, four strawberries. Five cherries.
Strawberries, cherries.
One peach, half a pineapple, a slice of melon, and something else. What is it?
A carrot?
Yes, a carrot.
Hooray!
Dinosaur juice for everyone.
Are you all enjoying Fruit Day?
Yes, we love fruit and carrots.
Everyone loves fruit and carrots.
Basketball.
It is a lovely sunny day. Peppa and her friends are in the school playground.
Children, today we have a special person coming to teach you basketball.
Ooh.
Hello!
Daddy! It isn't home time yet.
We've got a special teacher coming today.
That's me. I'm the coach.
A basketball teacher is called a coach.
Ooh.
That's clever, Daddy.
Peppa, call me coach.
Okay, Daddy coach.
Does anyone know how to play basketball?
No.
It's fun. You have to run, bounce the ball, and throw it through the hoop.
Wow! Easy peasy. Oh.
It is not as easy as it looks.
To play basketball, you need to train hard and keep fit.
Are you fit, Daddy Coach?
Yes, I'm super fit.
But Daddy Coach, you've got a big tummy.
This tummy is pure muscle. First, I'll teach you how to get the ball from here to here.
I can do that.
No, Daddy. You can't use your feet.
That's football.
Danny Dog likes football.
In basketball, you bounce the ball with your hands, like this. Who wants a go?
Me!
Susie Sheep is bouncing the basketball very carefully.
Well done, Susie. Now everyone try.
Everyone is learning how to bounce the ball.
Now I'll teach you tackling.
What's tackling?
Tackling is trying to get the ball from another player, like this. Try and get the ball from me, George.
George is very good at tackling.
Now throw the ball through the hoop. You need just a bit more training there, George. Let's have a little practice game. Split into two teams.
Boys against girls.
The girls are in one team, the boys are in the other.
That's not fair. We've got little ones on our team.
Don't worry, the boys' team will still win.
Yeah, we're a super team.
Emily Elephant is very good at reaching high with her trunk.
Emily's using her trunk. It's not fair.
Shush, Peppa. She's on our side.
Oh, yes, that is fair.
It's not fair. We want Emily on our team.
No, she's in our team.
Stop arguing. You can all be in the same team.
Okay.
The children are all in one big team.
Oh, but who will we play?
Hello.
The parents have come to take the children home.
I know. You can play the grown-ups.
But they are bigger than us.
Ah, but you've been taught basketball by Daddy Coach.
Yes. Let's play them.
We're the children's team.
Yay!
We're the grown-ups team.
All right!
I'm quite good at cricket.
Yes, well, this is basketball.
You throw the ball through the hoop.
But you can only use your hands.
Or your trunk.
But not your feet.
Ready, steady, go!
Mr. Elephant has the ball. Tackled by George. Pass to Zoe Zebra. To Richard Rabbit. And Peppa throws it through the hoop.
Yippee!
The children have won.
Hooray!
All thanks to Daddy Coach. Santa's Grotto.
It is Christmas Eve.
Hands up, who wants to go and see Father Christmas?
Me! Are we going to the North Pole?
Not quite that far, Peppa.
But Father Christmas lives at the North Pole.
Lucky for us, he's got a grotto at the Christmas fair.
Peppa and George have come to visit Santa's grotto.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
All aboard the elf train. This way to Santa's grotto.
Susie, what are you asking Father Christmas for?
I don't know. What are you asking for?
I would like a doll that walks and talks and closes its eyes when it goes to sleep.
I'll ask for that too.
How does Father Christmas remember what toys everybody wants?
He makes a list.
His sleigh must be very fast to go around the whole world in one night.
It's a super sleigh!
Father Christmas is really old.
He's hundreds of years old. Even older than my daddy.
Santa's Grotto!
Ooh. Ho, ho, ho! Hello, everyone!
Hello, Father Christmas!
Have you all been good?
Yes!
Have you all kept your bedrooms tidy?
Yes!
Have you?
Oh, of course. Now, come and tell me what you'd like for Christmas.
Can I have a football, please?
A xylophone.
Tiddlywinks.
A magic set, please.
Racing car.
Bouncy ball.
Boing, boing.
A train, please.
A toy train.
Not a toy.
toy train, a real train, one I can drive with real passengers.
Oh, I'll see what I can do. Is that everyone?
We haven't seen you yet.
I am sorry. What is your name?
I'm Peppa Pig. We've met before.
Ah, yes. Nice to see you again, Peppa. What would you like for Christmas?
I would like a doll that walks and talks and closes its eyes when it goes to sleep. Please.
The same for me, please.
Very good.
You do know where I live, don't you?
Oh, yes.
How old are you?
Oh, I'm hundreds of years old.
I told you.
Goodbye, Father Christmas.
Don't forget to leave me a mince pie
and a drink. We know.
And a carrot for the reindeer.
Ho, ho, ho.
Peppa and her family are driving back from the Christmas fair.
Daddy, why have we got our bags in the car?
We're spending Christmas at Granny and Grandpa's house.
But Father Christmas won't know where we are.
Don't worry, Peppa. Father Christmas knows everything.
Granny Pig, it's nearly Christmas.
Yes, and I've got a very important job for you. Stir the Christmas pudding and make a wish.
Peppa and George are making a wish.
Racing car.
Oh, don't tell me what it is.
Here's the mince pie and a drink for Father Christmas.
And a carrot for the reindeer.
Who can that be at this time of night?
We're not buying anything.
Merry joyful greetings, festive happy cheer.
Carol singers.
Bells falling gently, Christmas time.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
It is bedtime for Peppa and George.
This used to be my bedroom when I was a little piggy.
Father Christmas knows where Granny and Grandpa live, doesn't he?
Oh, yes. He's been here many times before. Good night, Peppa. Good night, George.
Peppa and George have fallen asleep. When they wake up, it will be Christmas Day.
Gym class.
Peppa and her friends are going to the gym today.
Let's check you've all got your gym kits on.
Pedro is wearing a superhero costume.
Pedro, where is your gym kit?
It's at home. I thought it was dressing up day.
Follow me, children.
This is the gym, where mummies and daddies come to exercise and enjoy themselves.
Are you all having fun?
Yes, lots of fun.
Your gym teacher for today is Grumpy Rabbit.
Where is he?
Hello, children. Are you ready to exercise?
Yes, Grumpy Rabbit.
Do we have to do that?
No, that's only for big athletes like me. Not for little explorers like you.
We're not explorers.
I'll make explorers of you, but you look like a superhero.
It's just pretend.
Pretending? That's good. Right, let's warm up. Everyone, run on the spot. And flap your arms. Now stretch. Stretch. Wobble like a jelly. And rest. Now we're all warmed up, we can start.
Start what?
Your adventure. I want you to pretend that this room is a jungle.
It doesn't look like a jungle.
Where are the trees?
You have to imagine it. The trees, the rain, the fast-flowing river at your feet. Your first adventure is to walk on this beam across the river.
Well, that's easy.
Ah, but it's night time and it's windy.
What?
That's how it was for me. It was a dark and stormy night. I was on an adventure. Ready?
But it's not windy or night time.
You have to pretend.
Everyone crosses the pretend river safely.
My little explorers.
What's next, Grumpy Rabbit?
Your next adventure is to swing across this swamp full of crocodiles.
Ah! I can't see any crocodiles.
You've got to pretend.
Let those crocodiles know who's boss.
Go away, you naughty crocodiles.
That's the spirit.
Did you ever swing across a crocodile swamp?
Of course I did.
Were you scared?
Not as scared as they were of me. Ready? Don't forget to do the call.
Everyone has crossed the pretend crocodile swamp safely.
Well done!
What's our next adventure?
This is a vault. Big athletes jump over it like this. But you can pretend it's a dinosaur and crawl through its legs.
Have you crawled through a dinosaur's legs, Grampy Rabbit?
Oh, yes. Once I was walking in the jungle when I stumbled into a lost world of dinosaurs. And that's it! You've made it out of the jungle!
Hooray!
Aho! Did you have a good gym class, children?
Yes, Madam Gazelle.
They're real little explorers now.
We walked across a river.
And we swung over crocodiles.
And we crawled under a dinosaur.
I love doing gym class with Grumpy Rabbit.
The Holiday House.
Peppa and her family are flying to another country for a holiday.
We hope you have enjoyed your flight. Please fasten your seatbelts.
This is Captain Emergency speaking. We are about to land in Italy.
Oh, Italy! That sounds nice.
The aeroplane has landed.
Hooray!
Oh dear. Peppa has left Teddy on the aeroplane.
Now we need a car to drive to our holiday house.
Here is the place to borrow cars.
Hello.
Buongiorno. Come posso aiutare una così bella signora?
In Italy, people speak Italian.
We need a car.
Non capisco.
Let me handle this. I'm an expert at talking. We need a car.
Uovo.
Not eggs. A car. No. Not flowers. No.
Brum, brum.
Ah, auto. Hey, hey. Brum, brum, beep, beep.
Well done, George. This bag is heavy. Are you sure we need everything in here, Mummy Pig?
Yes. It's all very important.
Are we going to get lost like we always do?
No, Peppa. The sat-nav will tell us the way.
Benvenuto all'auto del futuro.
In Italy, the sat-nav talks in Italian.
Proseguire sulla...
Maybe we don't need the sat-nav. Let's go this way.
Remember, Daddy Pig, this is another country. They may drive differently here.
Oh, oh, driving is driving, Mummy Pig. It can't be that different.
Strada, porco!
Driving in Italy is very different to driving at home.
Hello! Yes, we're on holiday.
Daddy, why are they beeping their horns at us?
I expect they're saying hello.
Can we say hello back?
Of course we can. Hello!
Everyone is so friendly here.
Peppa and her family are on their way to their holiday house.
Ah, we're almost there.
Yes, I can feel myself relaxing already.
Teddy! I love Teddy on the aeroplane!
Eh? What?
We have to go back for Teddy!
Oh, dear. It is a policeman.
Hello, officer. I don't know what I was doing wrong, but I promise I won't do it again.
Good day. I am returning this young bear. He was left on the aeroplane.
Oh, thank you.
Teddy!
Have a lovely holiday.
Here we are.
Peppa and her family have arrived at their holiday house.
What have you got in this bag, Mummy Pig?
It's all important stuff for our holiday. A lovely plant, our computer, tinned food, hot water bottles, some winter clothes in case it gets a bit chilly, the telephone.
Let's ring Granny and Grandpa.
Granny and Grandpa Pig are looking after Goldie the fish while Peppa is on holiday.
Are you sure we're feeding Goldie enough?
I'll just feed her a pinch more. Hello?
Hello, Granny. Can I speak to Goldie, please?
It's Peppa, for you.
I miss you too, Goldie.
It has been a long day. Now it is time for bed.
Good night, my little piggies.
Peppa and George are fast asleep in their holiday house.
The camper van.
Peppa and George are very excited today. They are going on holiday.
Oh, where's Daddy?
He's bringing a secret surprise.
What's that?
It's a camper van.
We've borrowed it for our holiday.
This camper van has everything. This button works the sink.
Wow!
And this button works the TV.
What does this button do?
I'm not sure. Maybe don't press it until we know.
Is everybody ready to go on holiday?
Yes, Mummy Pig!
Then let's go!
We're going on holiday in a camper van.
This map is a bit tricky.
Daddy, we don't want to get lost.
Don't worry, Peppa. I'm an expert at map reading. Oh, that's strange.
Are we lost?
Yes.
It's Grandad Dog with Danny Dog.
Hello, Peppa.
Hello, Danny. We're lost.
Lost? Is your sat-nav broken?
Sat-nav?
You're driving a camper van T3200. Sat-nav comes as standard.
Welcome to the car of the future.
Ah, so that's what that button does.
Where are we going today?
The camper van is talking.
Clever, isn't it? The computer voice helps you find your way.
But how does it know where we want to go?
You tell it.
Hello, Mrs. Campervan.
Hello.
We're going on holiday. Can you tell us the way?
Proceed on the current road in a straight line.
Thanks for your help, Grandad Dog.
You're welcome. Have a lovely holiday.
We're going on holiday in a campervan.
Danger, danger. Oil is low.
What's oil?
Oil helps engines to run smoothly.
Will the oil run out?
No. These warnings always give you plenty of time.
Oil is gone.
Oh, dear.
Luckily, I've got a spare can of oil.
Well done, Daddy Pig.
We simply pour the oil into the engine and... Oh.
What's wrong?
There's nothing in here. The engine's gone.
It's Mummy Sheep with Susie Sheep.
Hello, Susie.
Hello, Peppa.
We've lost our engine.
Lost your engine?
Yes. It's completely disappeared.
I'd like to help, but I don't know a thing about engines. I'm probably just being silly. This looks a bit like an engine.
Ah, yes. Well spotted, Mummy Sheep.
The camper van has its engine at the back.
There. That should be enough oil. Thank you, Mummy Sheep.
You're welcome. Have a lovely holiday.
Are we nearly there yet?
Just up the next hill. You have reached your destination.
Hooray!
Time for bed.
Where will we sleep?
Mummy Pig and I will sleep on this bed.
Ooh!
And you two will sleep upstairs.
But there isn't an upstairs.
Ho, ho, watch this.
The camper van's roof is lifting up.
The camper van is just like our little house.
While we're on holiday, it is our little house.
Good night, my little piggies.
Good night. Chloe's big friends.
Peppa and her family are on their way to visit Cousin Chloe.
I love playing with big Cousin Chloe. Chloe! Chloe! Oh, Chloe.
Hi there. These are my friends, Simon Squirrel and Belinda Bear.
You can call me Si. It's short for Simon.
And I'm Bee. It's short for Belinda.
I'm Peppa.
We'll call you Pep.
Oh, and this is George.
We'll call you Ja.
Oh.
You didn't tell us you had baby cousins, Chloe.
I'm not a baby.
But you're both little.
I'm a big girl. George is little.
Why don't we all play a game?
Yes, let's play hide and seek.
We don't play baby games anymore.
We're almost grown up.
What about the yes-no game?
What's the yes-no game?
I ask things and you answer.
What makes that a game?
You mustn't say yes or no.
Too easy.
Do you want to play then?
Yes.
Ah, you said yes.
That's not fair. I wasn't ready.
Bee, are you ready?
Yes.
Aha! I win again.
Peppa is very good at playing the yes-no game.
Can I ask the questions?
Of course.
You don't mind me asking you the questions?
I don't mind.
Am I ever going to make you say yes or no?
I don't think so.
Oh, I give up. How do you always win?
Easy. I just don't say yes or no.
Ah, I win. You said yes and no. That was fun.
Let's play another game.
Have you ever played sardines?
What's that?
Someone hides and we all try to find them.
That sounds like hide and seek.
But when you find them, you keep quiet and hide in the same space until everyone is hiding there.
Like sardines in a tin.
All right, let's try it.
George, you hide first.
1, 2, 3.
George is looking for somewhere to hide.
9, 10.
With your knot, here we come. George, I can see your wiggly tail.
Peppa is hiding with George.
Move over, George.
Found you.
Now Chloe must squeeze in with Peppa and George.
Move up.
There you all are.
Now Belinda Bear must squeeze in too.
Budge up. We're like sardines in a tin.
Where's everyone gone?
Surprise!
Ah! Can we stop running around now?
Yeah, let's just chill out.
Chill out? What's that?
We just sit around and talk about stuff.
I like talking. Blah, blah, blah.
Let's talk about music. I dig blues music.
I like red's music.
I like green's music.
We don't like children's music.
No, no, no.
What music are you into?
I like this. It's very grown up.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. And eyes and
home now. You will see Chloe again soon.
I'm coming to your house next week, Peppa.
Can we come along too?
You can come, but we will be playing games.
We like playing games with Peppa and George.
Hooray!
You can still have fun playing games, even when you're almost grown up.
Mr. Potato's Christmas Show.
It is Christmas time, and Peppa and her playgroup are going to the theatre to see Mr. Potato's Christmas Show.
We're here.
Look, it's the Christmas vegetable family.
Mr. Potato.
Mrs. Carrot.
Sweet Cranberry and Little Sprouts.
Here are your tickets. Find the seat with your number on it.
Here's my seat. Number 5.
6.
7.
8.
9.
10.
Quickly now, children. The show is about to begin.
Madame Gazelle, I need the toilet.
Oh, Pedro.
Sorry. Thank you.
Quickly now, Pedro.
I've never been to the theatre before. It's exciting, isn't it?
Sorry. Thank you.
Shh, children. Everyone quiet now.
What's that music?
The show is starting.
Oh, sorry, everyone.
It is not the start of the show. It is Madame Gazelle's phone ringing. Welcome to the Mr. Potato's Christmas Show, where the magic of vegetables never ends.
Ooh!
Hello, children. I am Mr. Potato. This is Mrs. Carrot. Here is Sweet Cranberry. And here is everyone's favorite Christmas vegetable, Little Sprout.
Where's Little Sprout gone?
Little Sprout, where are you?
He's lost.
Oh.
Can you help us find him, boys and girls?
Yes!
If you see him, boys and girls, shout out, there's Little Sprout!
There's Little Sprout!
That's it! When you see him, shout like that.
There he is! He's behind you!
Where?
There! Behind you!
I can't see him.
They're not very good at looking, are they?
There you are, you cheeky little sprout.
I'm the magic fairy carrot. Look, children, I can fly.
There's a string lifting her up.
I can grant you one wish. What do you wish for?
I wish we had a Christmas tree.
Your wish is my command.
Now we can sing our Christmas song. Would you like to hear it, boys and girls?
Yes!
Sweet little sprout on the Christmas tree, potatoes, carrots and cranberry.
It's a very special Christmas with all our friends, where the magic of vegetables never ends.
That's the end. Goodbye, children. Happy Christmas!
Happy Christmas, everybody!
That was a bit quick.
Wait, there's one more surprise.
A very important person has come to see you all.
Ho, ho, ho.
Can you guess who it is?
Ho, ho, ho.
It's the Queen.
It's Father Christmas.
Hooray!
Hello, children. Have you all been good?
Yes!
Have you all been cleaning your teeth?
Yes!
Have you kept your bedrooms tidy? Jolly good! Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Now, let's all sing our Christmas song.
Yes!
Grandpa's little train.
Peppa and George have come to play in Granny and Grandpa's garden.
What's that noise?
Grandpa's making something.
Hello, Peppa and George. That's perfect timing. I've just finished making it.
And may we ask what it is?
I'll show you.
Wow!
A little toy train.
It's not a toy. This is Gertrude. She's a miniature locomotive.
But doesn't it need railway tracks to run on?
Oh, no. I fitted Gertrude with car wheels so she can go anywhere she likes.
Grandpa, can we ride in Gertrude?
Hop aboard. Full steam ahead.
Bye-bye, Granny.
See you later.
Peppa and George love Grandpa's little train.
Grandpa's little train goes choo-choo-choo, choo-choo-choo, choo-choo-choo. Grandpa's little train goes choo-choo-choo all day long. And the piggies on the train go oink, 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 oink. And the piggies on the train go oink, oink, oink all day long.
Here is Grandad Dog with Danny Dog.
Hello.
Hello, Danny.
I see you're playing toy trains.
Toy? Gertrude isn't a toy. How's your little lorry?
Little lorry? My breakdown truck is a proper work vehicle.
Grandad, can I ride on the train?
It's your choice, Danny, if you'd rather play trains than...
Thanks, Grandad.
See you later.
Miss Rabbit is driving the school bus.
And to our left, we can see some hills with trees.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Peppa.
All Peppa's friends are here.
Can we ride on the train?
I'm giving the children an educational bus tour. Are trains educational?
They certainly are.
Hands up all those who want to ride on the train.
Me! Me!
And hands up all those who want to stay on the bus. OK. You can all go on the train and I'll follow along behind.
Grandma's little train goes choo-choo-choo, choo-choo-choo, choo-choo-choo. Grandma's little train goes choo-choo-choo all day long.
What a lot of mud.
We don't want to get stuck. Maybe we should go a different way.
It's only a patch of mud. Come on, Gertrude. You can make it.
Come on, bus. You can make it.
The bus is stuck in the mud.
Oh, bother.
Hello, Miss Rabbit. How are you today?
I'm a bit stuck. Can you rescue me?
Certainly.
Is your truck strong enough?
Trust me.
Did it work?
No. We need a vehicle with more power.
Can I help in any way?
It's nothing that I can't deal with. Thanks anyway.
I've got an idea. Grandpa Pig's train can tow me out of the mud.
Good thinking, Miss Rabbit.
Grandpa's little train is going to pull the bus out of the mud.
Full steam!
Come on, Gertrude!
Gertrude!
Oh, well done!
It's amazing what can be done by a toy train.
Toy? Gertrude isn't a toy.
Gertrude is the very best train in the whole world. Grumpy Rabbit's Lighthouse.
Peppa, George and Danny are having a day out on Grandad Dog's boat.
Can we go to Pirate's Island today?
Yes, Danny. But first, we've got to deliver supplies to my friend, Grumpy Rabbit.
Where does Grumpy Rabbit live?
On a rock.
On a rock?
Yes, in that lighthouse.
Ooh.
Ahoy there, matey! I brought your supplies!
Oh, thank you, Grandad Dog.
I've got my crew with me today. Danny, Peppa, and George.
Visitors? I haven't had visitors in many a moon. I get a bit lonely with just the sea and sky for company.
How long have you been here?
Since Tuesday.
Oh.
I've got tales to tell, if you'd like to hear.
No, thanks.
Yes, please.
Well, there's the sea and the sky and... I'm learning the banjo. Would you like to hear a song?
No, thanks.
Yes, please.
I got up this morning. The sea was still there. So was the sky.
The sea, the sky.
Here's your cheese.
Oh, I've missed cheese.
And a new book.
How to Run a Lighthouse. Oh, that'll come in handy.
Why is your house called a lighthouse?
I'll show you, Peppa.
The staircase goes round and round to the very top of the lighthouse.
Round and round and round.
It's called a lighthouse because it has this big light at the top.
Wow!
It shines through the dark, helping sailors to find their way.
Ooh.
And when it's foggy, I use this foghorn. Fog!
That's loud.
No fog today, just sea and sky. The stories I could tell.
No, thank you. We've got to go.
We're sailing to Pirate Island.
Goodbye, Grumpy Rabbit.
Enjoy the sea and the sky.
Hello.
Grandad Dog's boat has arrived at Pirate Island.
Look, our sandcastle is still here.
Let's play hide and seek.
Okay. One, two.
There are not many places to hide on Pirate Island.
Five. Ready or not, here I come. Found you.
Oh.
Now, where's George?
Grandad Dog cannot find George anywhere.
I give up. Where is he?
George was hiding behind Grandad Dog.
Clever George. Let's set off home before it gets dark.
It is getting dark.
Don't worry. The light from Grampy Rabbit's lighthouse will show us the way home.
Grampy Rabbit is ready for bed.
My new book, How to Run a Lighthouse. Chapter 1. I'll read the rest tomorrow. Better turn the light out.
Oh, where did the light go?
Do you know what time it is? I've just turned the lights out.
Yes, we know. Could you turn the big light on again?
Oh, sorry!
Hooray!
It is getting foggy.
I can't see the light anymore.
It's us again. Could you sound the foghorn?
Of course. Fog!
I can hear something.
Grampy Rabbit is guiding them home. His voice is a foghorn.
This way home!
The parents are here to pick up the children.
Have you had a lovely time?
We went to Pirate Island and to a lighthouse.
Grampy Rabbit's lighthouse guided us home safely.
That's nice.
Grampy Rabbit sang a song. Would you like to hear it?
No, thanks.
Yes, please.
I got up this morning. My cousin Chloe.
Peppa and George are playing in the garden.
To me, George.
You threw the ball too hard, George. So the rules say I win. Now it's my turn. I win again.
Peppa, George, today your big cousin Chloe is coming to visit.
Yippee, cousin Chloe. George, Chloe's a big girl, like me. So don't be sad if she finds you too little to play with.
Oh, I'm sure Chloe will play with both of you.
Chloe's here.
Auntie Pig has brought Chloe to spend the day at Peppa's house. Chloe is Peppa and George's cousin. Chloe is a bit older than Peppa and George.
Hello, Chloe.
Hello, Peppa. Hello, George.
See you later.
Do you want to play a game?
Yes, let's play catch.
Peppa loves playing catch.
Do you still play catch? That's a game for little children.
Oh, we only play catch because George likes it.
OK, let's play it for George. Do you play it with the proper rules or the baby rules?
Proper rules.
I'll start. Peppa, you're it. Catch me if you can.
Peppa is it. She has to chase Chloe and George.
Can't catch me.
George, I'm going to easily catch you. You're so little. That's not fair. You're helping George.
That's because he's little. Do you want me to help you?
No, I don't need help. I'm a big girl like you.
Come on then, Peppa. Try and catch us. Can't catch us. Can't catch us.
This is a silly game. Can we play something else?
Okay. I know a really good game for big children. It's called Sly Fox.
Sly Fox? I want to play Sly Fox. What is it?
One person is the sly fox, and the others creep up on them.
Me! I want to be the sly fox.
Peppa is the sly fox. While her back is turned, the others creep up on her. But if Peppa turns and sees someone move, they have to go back to the start.
George, I saw you move. Back to the start.
Got you. I win.
You moved before I was ready.
The rules say I can move when I like, don't they, George?
Now it's Chloe's turn to be the sly fox. Peppa and George must stay very still.
Ah!
Peppa, I saw you move. Back to the start.
It's not fair. You look too long.
The rules say I can look as long as I want. Back to the start.
George is the winner.
Can we play a different game?
Yes, but as long as it's a grown-up game.
I know! Let's play my favourite game. It's very grown-up.
George, do you know what Peppa's favourite game is?
Peppa's favourite game is jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
George, if you jump in puddles, you must wear your boots. I've brought some boots for you too, Chloe.
I'm too grown up to jump in muddy puddles.
Oh, so am I.
George loves jumping in muddy puddles. Secretly, Peppa would love to jump in the puddle, but she wants to look grown up.
I hear there's some puddle jumping going on.
Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig love jumping in muddy puddles.
It does look fun.
Yes, it does.
Maybe there's a rule that says big girls can jump in muddy puddles.
Yes, that's a good rule.
Race you!
Race you!
Peppa and Chloe love jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Everyone loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Even grown-up girls.
Windy autumn day.
Today, Peppa is going to the park.
It's freezing cold.
It is cold.
Quick, let's get our warm clothes on.
On cold days, Peppa and her family wear their hats and scarves and coats.
I'll put the roof up.
Oh, and let's get the heating on.
Everyone nice and warm?
Yes, Daddy Pig.
Then let's go.
This is the park.
We're here!
Hooray!
Mummy, why are all the leaves red and yellow?
It's autumn time, Peppa.
In the autumn, it gets a bit colder and the leaves change colour.
It's quite windy. Let's play a game to keep warm.
My turn! Oh, it's not meant to go that way.
The wind is blowing the ball along.
The ball is in the pond.
I'll just use this stick to reach it.
Just a bit further, Daddy.
Be careful, Daddy Pig.
Don't worry. I've almost got it.
Daddy, is the water cold?
A little bit.
The wind has blown the ball out of the pond.
That's lucky.
Yes, what a stroke of luck.
It's getting even windier. Hold on to your hats.
No, the wind has blown George's hat off.
Don't worry, George. Daddy Pig will catch your hat.
Quick, Daddy! Look! It's in that little tree.
I'll just climb up and get it.
The tree is much too thin to take your weight, Daddy Pig.
So, how can we get George's hat?
Simple. I'll give the tree a little shake. Huh. Maybe if I shake it a bit harder.
I thought that sort of thing only happened to me.
It's not funny.
It is a bit funny, Mummy.
I suppose it is a bit funny. Where's George's hat?
It's on your head.
Here's your hat, George. Hold on to it this time.
The wind is blowing all the leaves off the trees.
Look at me! I'm leaning into the wind.
The wind is strong enough to hold Peppa up. The wind is strong enough to hold George up.
Daddy, have a go.
I'm a bit too heavy.
Come on, Daddy. It's really fun.
All right.
The wind is strong enough to hold up Daddy Pig.
I say, this is fun. Come on, Mummy Pig, give it a try.
But if the wind stops, I'll fall over.
The wind won't just stop.
The wind has stopped.
It's not funny.
It is a bit funny.
Now the wind has stopped, what can we do?
What's your favourite game?
Jumping up and down in muddy puddles. But there aren't any puddles. Just lots of boring dry leaves.
And what do you do with dry leaves?
I don't know.
Jump up and down in them!
Daddy Pig loves jumping up and down in leaves. Peppa loves jumping up and down in leaves. Everyone loves jumping up and down in leaves.
This is the best autumn day ever. Pancakes!
It is tea time, and Mummy Pig has a surprise for everyone.
Today is a day for pancakes.
Pancakes? Delicious!
I love pancakes.
Everyone loves pancakes.
I'm the expert at flipping the pancakes over. Leave that to me.
Are you sure, Daddy Pig? Last time you got a bit grumpy when you dropped the pancake on the floor.
I did not get grumpy. There was a problem with the frying pan.
Mummy, can we help make the pancakes, please?
Yes, you can help me make the batter. First, I put some flour in the bowl.
Ooh!
Now I add an egg. Now the milk. And I give it all a stir.
Mummy, can I stir?
Yes, of course, Peppa.
Peppa loves stirring. George wants to stir as well.
No, George, like this.
Okay, that's enough stirring. You two sit at the table while I cook the pancakes.
Mummy Pig is going to flip the pancake over.
Hooray!
You could flip it higher, Mummy Pig.
You can show us how when you flip your own pancake, Daddy Pig.
This first pancake is for George. Mummy Pig pours a little syrup on George's pancake. Delicious. This pancake is for Peppa.
Hooray!
You could flip it higher, Mummy Pig.
You will get a chance to show me when you flip your own pancake, Daddy Pig.
Syrup, please. Delicious.
This pancake is for Mummy Pig.
Hooray!
You still aren't flipping them high enough, Mummy Pig.
The next pancake is yours, Daddy Pig. So now you can show us how it should be done. Delicious.
Is everyone watching? The secret of making a good pancake is to flip it high into the air. A one, two, three, hoopla!
Silly Daddy.
Oh, maybe that was just a bit too high.
Oh, what a shame. That was the last pancake.
It should be a simple matter to get it down.
Oh dear, Daddy Pig cannot reach his pancake.
Don't worry, Daddy Pig. I think I know a way to get it down. Let's go upstairs, children. This way.
What is Mummy Pig planning to do?
On the count of three, we all have to start jumping up and down. One, two, three, jump!
What are they doing?
It worked! Now Daddy Pig has his pancake.
Daddy has a pancake on his head.
Syrup on your pancake, Daddy Pig?
Yes, please. One, two, three, hoopla! Delicious.
Silly Daddy. The museum.
Peppa and her family are going to the museum.
Daddy, what is a museum?
It's a place full of interesting things that are very old.
Older than you?
Yes, even older than me.
Ooh, really old.
There's one room full of things that belong to kings and queens from long ago.
I went to see the king and queen's room.
And there's another room with a real dinosaur.
Wow, dinosaur.
Hello, Mummy Pig.
Hello, Miss Rabbit.
How many tickets, please?
Two adults and two children.
Dinosaur.
And a dinosaur.
Peppa wants to see the room full of things that belong to kings and queens from long ago.
Wow. Dinosaur?
But George wants to see the real dinosaur.
Don't worry, George. We will see the dinosaur next. Peppa, these are all the things that the Queen had a long time ago. This is the Queen's special chair. It's called a throne.
It's beautiful.
This is the Queen's dress.
It's so pretty.
Look, Peppa. This is the Queen's golden crown.
Wow! What lovely things. Mummy, where is the Queen's television?
They didn't have television then.
No television? But they did have computers.
No, they didn't have computers either.
What did they do all day? Mummy, if I was the Queen, I would eat as much cake as I wanted.
Peppa imagines being a queen.
Delicious.
Is there anything else you would care for, Queen Peppa?
Yes. More cake, please.
Of course.
Come on, everyone.
Coming, Daddy. Daddy, I'm Queen Peppa. You must bow when you speak to me.
Oh, I'm most terribly sorry, Your Royal Highness.
And what do you do?
I'm your daddy.
That must be very interesting.
Yes, it's very interesting.
And what room is this?
This is the dinosaur room.
The dinosaur room? George, this is the dinosaur room. Dinosaur! Where is the dinosaur?
He's somewhere in the room.
I can't see him. He must be very small.
Actually, Peppa, he's very big.
Wow!
These are the bones of a real dinosaur.
Dinosaur!
George imagines being a big dinosaur.
Ah! It's a dinosaur! Help! Help!
The dinosaur room is George's favourite room.
My favourite room is the King and Queen's room.
And it looks as if Daddy Pig is already in his favourite room.
Which room is that, Mummy?
The room with the cakes in.
Daddy Pig's favourite room is the museum cafe.
Come on, tuck in.
Oh, yes. This is a very nice room.
Going boating.
Peppa and her family have come to the lake to go boating.
Boats! Boats! Get your boats here!
What sort of boats do you have, Miss Rabbit?
I've got canoes!
Ooh, let's have a canoe!
You have to paddle a canoe? That's hard work.
I've got sailing boats.
It's a bit tricky to sail a sailing boat.
And I've got pedalos.
They look nice and relaxing.
Yes, they've got a big paddle wheel to make them go.
Let's have a pedalo.
When I ring this bell, it's time to bring the boat back. Enjoy your boat trip.
It's not moving.
No. How do we start the engine?
You're the engine, Daddy Pig. You have to pedal.
Oh, I see. Off we go, then.
It's a bicycle on the water.
Riding in a pedalo on a sunny lake. Daddy is the engine. I hope he doesn't break.
Here are Emily Elephant and her family.
Hello, Miss Rabbit. We'd like a canoe, please.
Certainly.
The elephant family like canoeing.
Paddles ready?
Yes, Daddy Elephant.
Then let's go.
Ahoy there, Miss Rabbit.
It is Danny Dog and his dad, Captain Dog.
We'd like a boat, please.
Certainly. I have canoes, sailing boats or pedalos.
I didn't sail the world and make my fortune to splash around in a pedalo. We'll take the sailing boat.
Do you know how to work it?
Do I know how to work it? I'm Captain Dog. Ruff! Come on, Danny. All aboard! Full sail!
Aye, aye, Captain Dad.
Hello, we're sailing.
We're canoeing.
We're pedalling. Look, an island.
We could go there for our picnic.
Hooray!
Oh. The island is a bit small to have a picnic on.
We can have our picnic in the boats.
Who'd like a sandwich?
Me, please.
Here's some bread, Mrs. Duck.
Mrs. Duck loves picnics. Everyone loves picnics.
Come in, boats! 1, 2, and 3! Your time is up!
1, 2, and 3! That's us!
Let's see who can get back first. We'll have a race!
Yes!
Pedal faster, Daddy!
Daddy?
I'm not sure I can pedal much faster.
Oh, Daddy Pig, I'll do the pedalling.
Quicker, Mummy!
This is quite hard work, isn't it?
Aha! We'll be carried back by the wind, Danny.
Oh.
What is it?
The wind has stopped.
Without any wind, the sailing boat cannot go.
We'll just have to wait for the wind to pick up again.
How long will that take?
I don't know. It could be weeks.
Can't we use the engine?
Oh, you don't have engines on sailing boats, Danny.
Oh.
The sailing boat does have an engine.
Full sail!
Emily and her family are in the lead.
Pedal faster, Mummy!
Oh.
We're going to win the race!
Here come Danny and Captain Dog.
Hooray! We win!
That was exhausting. Next time we'll take a sailing boat.
Yes, sailing boats have engines on them.
Daddy?
See you later, Danny. I've decided to sail around the world again.
But you said you were going to stay home.
Oh, yes. I'm not a sailor anymore. But I do love boating on the lake.
Everyone loves boating on the lake.
Holiday in the sun.
It is the first morning of Peppa and her family's holiday in Italy.
Ah, holiday.
Daddy Pig is up bright and early.
I'll just go for a little walk.
Good morning, Mr. Pig. I see you have found the swimming pool.
This is Signor Goat. It is his job to look after the holiday house.
Daddy fell in the water.
It's not funny.
It is quite funny, Daddy.
Ho, ho. I suppose it is a bit funny.
This is my daughter.
Hello, I'm Gabriella Goat.
I'm Peppa Pig.
Tell us if you need anything at all.
We'd like to do some sightseeing.
The village is very pretty. I will show you.
Okay, I'll just change out of these wet clothes. I don't look like a tourist, do I?
You look perfect.
Is everybody ready?
Yes, Daddy Pig.
Then let's go.
This is Gabriella's village.
Here is the shop of my auntie.
Can I send a postcard?
Who is it for?
A goldfish.
A goldfish? Maybe a postcard of the sea.
Yes, Goldie the fish likes water.
Bongo drums, carpets, garden gnomes. Who buys all this rubbish?
Tourists.
Oh, hello.
Buongiorno.
Mummy Pig is buying lots of things to take home.
Mummy Pig, we haven't got room for all this in our suitcase.
Don't worry, Daddy Pig. They sell suitcases too.
This is the village cafe.
Ciao, Gabriella.
My uncle makes very good pizza.
You eat pizza in Italy?
Pizza is Italian food.
Oh, goody. I like pizza.
A little bit of tomato, a little bit of cheese, into the oven and...
into my tummy.
Maybe we let them cook first, no?
Okay.
Peppa, let's write the postcard to your goldfish.
Yes, I miss her very much.
To Goldie, wish you were here.
Love and kisses, Peppa.
You can post the card here.
Goodbye, postcard. Fly home quickly.
Pizza, pizza, pizza.
Mmm, yummy.
Peppa loves pizza. Everybody loves pizza.
Did you like that, Teddy?
Yes, it was delicious.
Magnifico, Uncle Goat. There will always be a special place for your pizza in my tummy.
Thank you.
Ciao.
Goodbye.
Oh, dear. Peppa has left Teddy behind at the cafe.
What a lovely, relaxing holiday we're having. Oh, dear. It's the police.
Leave the talking to me. Hello, officer. I don't know what I did, but I won't do it again.
Mr. Pig, your teddy.
Teddy!
Thank you.
Just doing my job, signora.
Peppa and her family have arrived back at their holiday house.
Time for bed.
Can we ring Goldie the fish, Mummy?
Okay.
Granny and Grandpa Pig are looking after Goldie the fish while Peppa is on holiday.
I do hope we're feeding Goldie enough. Hello?
Hello, Grandpa. Is Goldie all right?
Goldie is fine.
I sent her a postcard today. Has it arrived?
Oh, not yet, but I'm sure it will get here soon.
Night-night, Grandpa.
Night-night, Peppa.
Peppa and George are fast asleep in their holiday house.
Mr. Skinnylegs.
Peppa is playing with her doll's house. George is playing too. Peppa is making a tea party for the doll family.
Here, George. I'm the mummy and daddy. You can be the children. Children, it's nearly tea time, so you must wash your hands.
George is putting the dolls to bed.
Night, night. George, why are you putting the children to bed? They're having a tea party.
George likes putting the dolls to bed.
Children, come downstairs right now, or you won't get any cake.
George isn't listening. He's too busy putting the dolls to bed.
George, if you want to play with my doll's house, you have to help with the tea party. Here, George, you can fill the teapot with water. Children, come downstairs right now. Mummy, we're coming.
George is going to fill the teapot with water.
Ooh.
George has found a spider in the sink. George wants the spider to be his friend.
Oh.
George likes the spider. The spider likes George. Peppa loves playing tea parties.
Where are all the chocolate biscuits, Daddy? We had lots yesterday.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mummy. I must have eaten them all. Ho, ho, ho.
Naughty Daddy.
George is putting the spider to bed.
Night, night. George, what are you doing? You have to help me with the tea party. Help! Help! Daddy! There's a spider in my bedroom.
Oh, don't worry, Peppa.
Please, Daddy. Take it away.
No need to panic. Hello, George. Have you seen the spider?
It's too scary. Take it away.
There's no need to be afraid, Peppa. Spiders are very, very small and they can't hurt you. But don't worry. Daddy will take it out of the bedroom. Whoa! He's quite big, isn't he? I'll just fetch Mummy Pig. Mummy Pig!
Hello, Mr. Skinnylegs.
Peppa feels a little bit braver.
He likes being in my doll's house.
Hello, children. I hear you found a little spider. I'll take him out of the bedroom so you two can play.
Mummy, his name is Mr. Skinnylegs.
Ah! Mr. Skinnylegs is big, isn't he?
Peppa and George like the spider.
Night, night.
George is putting the spider to bed.
No, George. He wants some tea. He doesn't want to be in bed. Are you hungry, Mr. Skinnylegs? Would you like some cake?
Peppa isn't afraid of the spider anymore.
Mummy, Daddy, sit down. We are all going to have tea with Mr. Skinnylegs. Who wants tea?
Me, please.
Me, please.
T-
delicious.
Peppa loves playing tea parties.
Here's your tea, Mr. Skinny Legs. What's that? You want to say hello to my daddy? Hello, Mr. Daddy Pig.
Hey, that's all right, Peppa. Let Mr. Skinny Legs drink his tea.
You're not scared, are you, Daddy?
Oh, no, of course not. Well, not so close. Whoa!
Peppa likes Mr. Skinny Legs. Everyone likes Mr. Skinny Legs.
Dressing up.
Peppa and George are playing in Mummy and Daddy's bedroom.
What's this?
Peppa has found a box of old clothes.
Wow! This is Daddy's hat. And this is Mummy's dress. George, let's dress up and pretend to be Mummy and Daddy. Here's Daddy's hat. And here is Daddy's coat. Hello, Daddy Pig. Now it's my turn. This is Mummy's dress. This is Mummy's hat. Daddy Pig, where are your shoes? I need some shoes too. Now I need to look beautiful, just like Mummy.
Peppa has found Mummy's makeup box.
Aha! First some powder. Lovely. Now for some lipstick. What a pretty Mummy Pig. Come along, Daddy Pig. It's time to go to work.
Mummy Pig is working on her computer.
Hello, Peppa. Hello, George.
I beg your pardon.
Peppa, I was just saying hello.
I'm not Peppa Pig. I'm Mummy Pig.
Oh, yes, of course. Hello, Mummy Pig.
Hello. And this is Daddy Pig. George.
And hello to you too, Daddy Pig.
Excuse me, I've got a lot of work to do. Hello?
Yes?
Do this, do that.
No,
thank you.
Goodbye.
Peppa is enjoying pretending to be Mummy Pig. But George is getting a bit bored.
Sorry, Daddy Pig. I'm nearly finished. There, all done. Come on, Daddy Pig, it's time you did some work.
Goodbye, Mummy Pig and Daddy Pig.
Goodbye.
Daddy Pig is digging in the garden.
Hello, Peppa. Hello, George.
I'm not Peppa. I'm Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Daddy Pig is here to do some work.
That's very kind of you, Daddy Pig. Now be careful. It's a very deep hole.
I hope you are not digging in your best clothes, Daddy Pig. I want to make big snorts too.
Ice cream, everyone!
Ice cream!
Peppa, George, you must take off those muddy clothes before you eat.
I'm Mummy Pig and this is Daddy Pig.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So, where are Peppa and George?
We don't know.
Oh, well, that's a shame because I've got their favourite ice cream here. But if we can't find them, then...
Here we are!
Peppa? George? There you are!
Yes, Mummy. We were just pretending to be you and Daddy.
You really had us fooled.
Oh.